Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to brilliant.org/scishow to check out their applied probability course and for 20% off an annual premium subscription. For something so relaxing, sleep is actually surprisingly complicated. We spend about a third of our lives sleeping, but there is a lot we still don't know about it. Like, how do we know when our bodies get tired? How do I sense that sensation? Scientists have pondered this question for a long time, and they might just have gotten close to solving the mystery. Sleep is driven by two factors. One is the circadian rhythm, which our body systems go through over a 24-hour day. And the second one is homeostatic sleep pressure, which is when your need for sleep increases the longer you stay awake, and decreases the longer you sleep. So in essence, circadian rhythms determine when you sleep, while your drive for sleep is more influenced by homeostatic sleep pressure. But scientists are not totally sure what drives homeostatic sleep pressure. So they have looked to other processes that follow the same pattern as homeostatic sleep pressure, like DNA damage in cells, which also increases while we are awake or sleep-deprived and decreases during sleep. The DNA in your cells accumulates damage throughout the day. For instance, UV light can damage the DNA in your skin cells. If the DNA isn't repaired, it could lead to things like mutations or cell death. Most of these DNA errors are fixed as they happen, but neurons can't fix DNA damage until you are asleep. That means that DNA damage in neurons builds up during the day when we are awake. So scientists in Israel hypothesized that this buildup in the brain is what increases sleep pressure, which makes us feel tired. And they tested this hypothesis using zebrafish larvae because they have similar neuron systems to humans, and they regulate their sleep in a similar way. When the researchers damaged the DNA in neurons of zebrafish larvae, sure enough, they fell asleep more quickly and got more sleep than they normally did. And the more damaged their DNA was, the more they slept. Once their DNA was back to normal, so were their sleep patterns. But the scientists wanted to know what it was about damaged neuronal DNA that told the fish to sleep. So they looked at a protein called PARP1, which detects DNA damage and flags it to start the repair response. And they found that levels of this protein shoot up in the zebrafish's neurons during the day alongside the buildup of DNA damage, then drop back down throughout the night as the damage is repaired. Scientists also deprived the fish of sleep and found that there was even more PARP1 present than normal, exactly the same as in homeostatic sleep pressure, which increases as you stay awake. They also forced fish cells to have more PARP1 than normal, and when they did that, the zebrafish slept more, and when they blocked PARP1 from flagging DNA damage, the fish slept less. Specifically, they slept less near the end of daylight and throughout the night, or the exact times you would expect sleep pressure to be at its highest. It was like the fish didn't know they were tired. Now, we can't say for sure that zebrafish feel tiredness in the same way that we do, because zebrafish cannot tell us how they're feeling. But this is still a great starting point to better understand the role of DNA damage and sleep in all sorts of things, including neurodegenerative diseases and aging. And at the very least, it is a great excuse to take a nap. And if you'd like to calculate the probability that you will sleep more than you intend to during your next nap, you should check out today's sponsor, Brilliant. They are an online learning platform with courses about science, engineering, computer science, and math, and they have a whole interactive course on applied probability where they can guide you on cultivating a more quantitative worldview. If you'd like to give Brilliant a try, you can sign up at brilliant.org/scishow to save 20% off an annual premium subscription. Checking them out also supports us. So thanks.